Hello, this is Narasimhulu from KG Reddy College of Engineering and Technology, Department of Mathematics. So today we are going to discuss non-singular matrices, its PAQ form, okay? This PAQ form we got from normal form. So using this matrix, we need to find P matrix, Q matrix, and also find the rank also, okay? So for this, so come to the solution process. So A equals to, so formula is IM into A into IN. So this means A equals to given matrix only. This is equals to identity matrix of mth row. How many rows are given in the problem? So based on that we have to write here. This A is as it is matrix, write down. This IN, identity matrix. So how many columns are given in the matrix? So based on that we have to write. So therefore A equals to I M. M means how many rows are given here? 3 rows are given. For that I3 into A into I, 4 columns are given in the problem. So that's what I4. So now write down matrix. A equal to given matrix only. 1, 3, 6, minus 1 is the first row. Second row 1, 4, 5, 1. Third row 1, 5, 4, 3. So this is left to hand side. This is equals to right hand I3 means identity matrix of 3 by 3 size. So means 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. This matrix size is 3 by 3 into A is as it is write down into I4 means identity matrix of size 4. So it means 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So these are the matrices. Now come to the left side matrix. Here we need to apply row operation and also column operation. So until we need to get identity matrix in the left side. Okay. So this is one procedure. And one more point here. When you are applying row operation in the left side, same operation we can apply in the RHS of prefactor matrix only. First matrix is called as prefactor, second matrix is called as postfactor. Okay. So here we are applying row operation in the left side means we need to apply same operation in the prefactor. That is first point. And the second point, when we are applying column operation in the left side, same column operation we can apply in the RHS of post factor. Okay. So these are the conditions. Left side we need to get normal form, that is identity matrix. Come to right side, we'll get one matrix. This first matrix is called as P and the last matrix is called as Q. Okay. So left side we'll get identity matrix. Based on the identity matrix size only, we can calculate this rank. So this is the problem procedure. So come to this. So first element already we have one. Using this, we have to make it these two zeros. So for that, R2 employs. So 1, 1 we have here, R2 minus R1. Next come to the third row, R3 employs, R3 minus R1. Means what? We are applying row operation. Row operation in the means, we can apply in left side, we can apply in right side of prefactor matrix. So first row is same, 1, 3, 6, minus 1. Second row we can change using R2 minus R1, means 1 minus 1, 0, 4 minus 3 is 1, 5 minus 6 is minus 1, 1 minus of minus, means 1 plus 1 is 2. Second row completed. Come to third row, 1 minus 1 is 0, 5 minus 3 is 2, 4 minus 6 minus 2, 3 minus of minus, it's 4. Now left side matrix is completed. This is equal to right side prefactor matrix. We need to apply these two formulas. Okay. For that, first row is same, 1, 0, 0. Second row using the formula of R2 minus R1, 0 minus 1, it's minus 1. 1 minus 0, 1. 0 minus 0, 0. Come to the last row, R3 minus R1, 0 minus 1, minus 1. 0 minus 0, 0 only. 1 minus 0, 1. Now prefactor also completed into A, into post factor matrix as it is write down, because we are applying only row operation. So this matrix as it is write down 0, 0, 0, 1. Now come to the column operation. Okay, we applied already row operation. After that, alternatively column operation we have to apply. So here first element is 0, 1. So using this, we need to make it this 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Because we have to focus on identity matrix. That identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 0 like that. So for that, this column is C1, C2, C3, C4. So using C1 we are doing. So that's what? C2 implies 3 here, 1 here. So that's what? C2 minus 3C1, right? Now go to C3. So third column, 6-1. So C3 minus 6C1. Next go for C4. So C4 formula is minus 1 plus 1. C4 plus C1, right? Now we are applying column operation. So here right side we can apply in the post factor now. Okay, come to the first column. First column is as it is write down 1, 0, 0. Second column we can use this formula C2 minus 3C1. 3 minus 3, first 0. 1 minus 3 into 0, 1 only. 2 minus 3 into 0, 2 only. Come to the third column. C3 minus 6C1, 6 minus 6. So here 0, minus 1, minus 6 into 0, minus 1 only. So here minus 2 only. Third column also completed. Come to fourth column. C4 plus C1, minus 1 plus 1, 0 here. 2 plus 0, 2. 4 plus 0, 4. Left side matrix is completed. Come to the RHS. We need to apply this formula in the post factor only. For that, this prefactor matrix write down as it is 1, 0, 0, minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 1. As it is matrix, I am writing here into A. Now we need to do change post factor only. First column here same 1, 0, 0, 0. Second C2 minus 3C1, C2 minus 3C1, 0 minus 3, so minus 3. 1 minus 0, 1 only, right? So 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0 only. Come to C3 formula, C3 minus 6C1, 0 minus 6, it will get minus 6. So here both are zeros only. So here 1 minus something into 0, 0 only, 1. So remaining is 0, okay? Come to the last to C4, 0 plus 1, C4 plus C1, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 0, 0, 1 plus 0, 1. Now we applied column operation. Now go for row operation. Okay, so if you apply alternatively, then we'll get very easy for this solution. So now come to the row operation. So in the first column, using this already we made it two zeros. Now coming to the second column, in the second column we need to choose this element. Using this we have to make it this zero, right? So now we need to change just R3 only using R2. What is the formula here? R3 minus 2R2. Now first row is same 1, 0, 0, 0. Second row also same 0, 1, minus 1, 2. Third row R3 minus 2R2, 0. R3 minus 2R2, 0. R3 minus 2, minus of minus plus 2, 0. So here R3 minus 2R2, 4 minus 4, 0. Left side matrix is completed. Come to the right side. We need to apply this row operation in prefactor only, because we are applying row operation. Now we have to change only R3. For that, first two rows are same. 1, 0, 0, minus 1, 1, 0. R3 minus 2R2, minus 1, minus of minus plus. Minus 1 plus 2, it's 1. 0 minus 2, it's minus 2. 1 minus 2 into 0, 1 only. So prefactor is completed into A. Post factor matrix as it is write down 1, minus 3, minus 6, 1. Okay. So second row 0, 1, 0, 0. Third row 0, 0, 1, 0. Fourth row 0, 0, 0, 1. Now row operation is completed. Come to the column operation. In this column operation, we need to focus on identity matrix 0 1 0 0 0 1 0. We have to make it this 0, right? So last row anyway we got all the zeros only. So that's what, at present I'm changing C3 and C4. So therefore C3 employs -1 + 1, it will get 0. So for that C3 + C2 I'm doing here. Okay. Now come to the C4, employs C4 - 2C2. Then we'll get here 0 directly, right? So first column is same 100, second column 010, third column C3 + C2 0 + 0 0, -1 + 1 0, 0 + 0 0. Now come to the C4, 0 - 2 × C2 0 only, 2 - 2 it will get 0, 0 - 0 0, right? Left to side matrix is completed. Come to the right side matrix. So this is called as column operation. We need to apply in the post factor only. Okay. So that's what, this pre-factor matrix write down as it is. 100 - 1 10 1 - 2 1 × A into post factor matrix. We can change C3 and C4 only. For that, first two columns are as it is write down. Second column -3 1 0 0, third column C3 + C2, C3 + C2, -6 - 3, it's -9, 0 + 1 1 only, 1 + 0 1, 0 + 0 0. Now C4 - 2C2, so -(-)(+)(3)(2)(6+1)(7). Next here 0 - 2, -2 only, 0 0 0 only, 1 0 1 only. So now come to the left side matrix. Already we got identity matrix, because except to zeros and ones we don't have any elements, right? See, totally 1 and 0 only, we got totally 0. So come to here, we got identity matrix of size 2, 1 0 0 1. Except this, remaining all the elements are, we got 0. So that's what, already we got normal form or canonical form. So this rank of A matrix is equals to 2, because this matrix size is 2 only, that is 1 0 0 1 only. Okay, so rank is completed. Next we need to find P and Q value. Come to the right side matrix. Pre factor matrix is called as P matrix, post factor matrix is called as Q matrix. Okay, so therefore P equals to this and also Q equals to this matrix. So this is totally non-singular matrices. Okay, once again I'm repeating this question. So we need to find non-singular matrices, that form is P and Q. After completion of this, we have to find the rank. Okay, so this is the formula of system of linear equations. So here how many rows are given in the row, how many columns are given in the column, okay, matrix. So based on that, write down matrices. Now apply row operation and column operations alternatively until we need to get identity in the left side. So already we got identity matrix in the left side. Now we are finding rank of A. So right side we got two matrices. First matrix is called as P, second matrix is called as Q. So this is the form of PAQ. So and rank of A is equals to 2. So this is the non-singular matrices conditions. Thank you so much.